Time for some Dark Souls 3. Blind play. I'm thinking I've got this numbering scheme wrong. It's either 7 or 8, but I guess we'll correct that in the description. I think it's time to take on this boss. And actually successfully defeat him instead of being defeated. It's not letting me log into the Dark Souls 3 game server. No, I think it was just mostly a network issue. Yeah, so Dark Souls playthrough 7 or 8. Where we left off was... We've got several things that I can actually check out now that I think about it. I was trying to find Grey Rat, but he wasn't here. Try alone. I've also got a tip to go to the base of Lothric and look for a jail cell. And you know what? The NPC that would fill in my statement is gone. I don't know where he is. This guy just kind of shows up when he wants to. But he wants me to go kill a dark wraith in jail cell, basically. And I don't know where that is. I have an idea of where it is, but I think it's going to take a little time to find it. Because it's going to take some exploration, regardless.
Ah, well, how may I be of service?
I'm trying to remember what these did in the first Dark Souls, the dried fingers. I know, I might as well buy them, because... Or max out my wood arrows. I'm gonna go ahead and buy this. Dried fingers. And I'm just gonna max out all the arrows. Okay.
Ashen One, be sure to bring more souls.
I'll do that. I'll make sure to bring more souls to you. Dried finger with multiple knuckles, used to strengthen connection to other worlds, allowing the summoning of a third phantom. But also a second dark spirit. Also makes the summoning of a dark spirit occur earlier. Use with caution. Oh, so that's kind of cool. So now with this dried finger, I can actually summon three people in my game. That's going to make some boss fights a lot easier. Sniper. Alright, so I do remember there's a giant enemy up here that Zygvard was saying was responsible for shooting those giant arrows at us down below in the Undead Settlement. And there is a gigantic dude here. I'm wondering if I can actually do some damage to him. Talk.
Who are you? I help anytime. I help anytime.
Really? So now you're gonna help. What, he gave me a fragrant branch? Branch of a white birch received from a giant, apparently it's a token of friendship. Become something that blends into the surroundings, consumed with use. Good friend, no hit. What the heck were you throwing them for to begin with? I'll go ahead and rate that message because, yeah, it's a friendly NPC. I don't want any people to come up here immediately attack the guy and then he just one-shots him. You know what, there was also a ring that I freed from a corpse hanging from a tree. First bonfire and then the settlement to get it.
Like poking around in cells, do you? How very genteel. Ah. Taking an interest in her, have you? Which is a lost cause. Couldn't even become a firekeeper. After I brought her all this way and got her all ready. She's beyond repair, I tell you.
Who the hell is he talking about?
The woman's a lost cause. Couldn't even become... She's beyond repair.
Huh. Does not open from this side. There's a hanging corpse right there. I'm gonna make this easy on myself. I'm gonna backtrack. I'm gonna use the bonfire to travel to the very beginning of the Undead Settlement. I'm gonna try to pick up that, the loot off that corpse from earlier. dilapidated bridge. I don't remember where is a dilapidated bridge. I think Cliff Underside. No, this one, Undead Settlement. I think this is going to be the quickest way to get to the item. Holy crap, you can actually see the giant up there with the bow in his hand. And he's firing. I never noticed that before. That's cool. That really is cool. They didn't have to do that. That ring is right over there. Well, it's, I don't know if it's a ring. I had a message probably about 3 or 4 videos back that alluded that there was a ring at the end of this pathway off to the right of this dilapidated tower, and I never saw it. At the time, but now I'm thinking that that hanging corpse was what they were talking about. And now that I've freed it, I'm gonna see what this ring is. Visions of ambush. Yeah, this is annoying right here, but I'm glad I bought some arrows. guess another one fell off the cliff's edge. You know what? There's something back there. I can't believe I missed that. I know where that is. I guess I'll have to go back. I'm not going to be able to reach it too easily from here, but... It actually fell down there now. Okay. That was weird because it... I guess it reset. Because I shot it from down there. Last time. Oh well. I have like no Estus Blast, and the mobs are gonna reset. Verge of dying.
Yeah.
Fallhood? That's the first time I've obtained that item. Hood used to cover the head of lesser folk who were set to work as slaves throughout Lothric. Also occasionally used to shame and humiliate criminals. It's pretty bad in every way. Yeah. Looks kind of badass. This guy. This is what you get for buying cheap arrows. It didn't reset. Well, that was kind of all for naught, really. Alright, so now, if I'm correct, there should be two dogs back here that I missed. And there are. And they almost killed me. And all it was a luring skull. Nah. That was really not worth it. But maybe this is. And you know what? It is a ring. It's the Flame Stoneplate ring. So let's take a look at it. Increased fire damage absorption. Stone plates are symbols of true knights, and red stone plates are granted to those who valiantly face chaos. Increases fire damage absorption. rings can I equip? Four? Okay. Let's see if somebody died by falling here. No, it looks like he aggroed this NPC, and I don't have any plans on doing that. At all. I mean, all those messages are good, but I just don't feel like raiding them. I don't remember where this is. Dilapidated bridge. Check it out, because I feel like the only thing left is to take out this tree demon, and also kind of want to see if this giant is still going to be shooting arrows at us. Okay, I vaguely remember this now. You know, it just occurred to me, the reason why I'm not seeing any freaking summon signs is because I need to use incubated. I always keep forgetting to do that. I mean, an ember. Giant machete has a slash attack and is a worker's tool in the undead settlement. This dismantling tool was not originally intended for use in battle. I'm not summoning a mad phantom. Earth Phantom. Now that I'm friendly, he's not gonna shoot me. Where the heck is he? Young White Brand. I just have to leap across here. Okay. Undead bone shard. Undead bones that yet to burn. Cast it into the shrine bonfire to boost the recovery provided by the essence flask. I definitely need that. The bonfire cinders are the bones of undead, and a bone that still burns is the first cinder. Before feeding upon death, one must first pray to it. Really? That was a bad jump. A really bad jump. And that was a lost ember. This character just looks weird. I don't even know. This dude, Izumi, he spent some time on designing his character. Look how big his nose is. Looks like a crow or something. Or from that movie Beetlejuice. Glad I made friends with that guy. Mortician's ashes? This is some weird... I have no idea what that process is. I'm about to clear it here. I didn't even look at this. Sick Growl. Special brew of Siegfried or Katarina, perfect for travel in this jolly barrel mug. Restores HP and temporarily boosts frost resistance. Leave it to Siegfried to discover a drink that even an undead can enjoy. Perhaps his long years spent undead have left him wanting to drain a cup or two and revel as if he were still among the living. Enters an ash. Mortician's ash. That's what it was. Because these guys won't, you know. These guys are helping. They're here to help me with the boss more than anything. And there might be a third phantom out there. So I guess we'll go ahead and take it on, the demon, whatever the heck it is. What the heck was that about? Like, what was the point in them even... They, like, left my game right when I went to the fog wall. Freaking jerk-offs. Alright, where's this mortician's ash? Umbral ash of a resident of the undead settlement who made a living burying corpses, but this, the shrine handmade, will repair new items. Cool. Okay, so this leads to the same way. I don't understand why he wanted to go this way. Rotted Greatwood and transposing kiln. I felt like I didn't do much, though. Soul of the Cursed Rite of Greatwood, one of the twisted souls steeped in strength. Used to acquire many souls or transposed to extract its true strength. Ever since its establishment, all manner of curses have managed to seep into the undead settlement. The worst of them were sealed away inside of a spirit tree, but eventually the curses took their toll. Vertebra Shackle. A special bone collected by members of the Covenant of Mound Makers discovered in the corpses of their victims. Only one such bone is found in the vertebra, and the Mound Makers believe it to be a shackle of the gods. In their minds, each victim is another connection in addition to the family. We've also got some cleric gear to take a look at. In the transposing kiln. An old transposing kiln from Corlin, crafted with stitched crystal lizard hide. Give to Lidleth, Lord of Cinder, to conduct soul transposition. This kiln can transpose twisted souls to craft special items with their concentrated essence, deemed forbidden by those unable to make proper use of it. I guess it wasn't a cleric's weapon. I think I picked this up, though. The blue wooden shield. Yeah, a wooden shield painted bright blue, the symbol of clerics who have become undead, close to a small shield in size. Wooden shields are light, manageable, and offer relatively high magic absorption. A little bit more stable. It's overall better. It weighs a little bit more, though. A cleric hat. Hat worn by a cleric turned undead. Typical attire for blue-robed travelers. It is said that they were entrusted with a duty. Still, its nature is yet to be revealed. Cleric blue robe. Garb worn by a cleric turned undead. Unmistakable vibrant blue robes. It is said that the blue-robed travelers were entrusted with a duty. They bore large covers on their backs to ensure that they would not become seedbeds for spreading darkness. Cleric gloves. Gloves worn by a cleric turned undead. Typical attire for blue robe travelers. It is said that they were entrusted with the duty. Still, its nature is yet to be revealed. Trousers worn by a cleric turned undead. Typical attire for blue robe travelers. It is said that they were entrusted with the duty. Still, its nature is yet to be revealed. Let's see if there's a bonfire. And I noticed that I chugged like three or four Estuses in the middle of the fight. Unintentionally, because I was thinking, you know, being conditioned from the first Dark Souls, that while you're in the middle of an animation of drinking your, let's say you drink one Estus, or you initiate the frames to drink one Estus, And you're walking around, and you think you're going to take so much damage that you need to follow it up with a second. Well, that's what I was doing. I was walking around, and I was tap, 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 tap. I was tapping my Estus flask, and I didn't realize that in this game, apparently, the time it takes between drink frame A and drink frame Bravo is very short. And I ended up basically drinking two or three Estuses back to back without realizing it. And the reason why this is an issue is because back in Dark Souls 1, you had to wait until the full animation effect was done after drinking your first Estus before you would go into the animation frames for drinking the second Estus. So a lot of times, you could sit there while you're trying to back away from the fight and you're just spamming square because you want to initiate that second frame as soon as possible. That way you can get the health recovery. But apparently in this game, I'm going to have to learn that you don't need to do that. You don't need to spam square because the animation frames are a lot quicker. So I can basically queue up two Estus drinks, probably with just two presses of the square button. May the flames guide thee. Poor soul. old Kaja. We'll light the bonfire. And I think we're pray at the sacrificial altar. What in the world? I guess I'll offer this vertebra shackle. Covenant allegiance deepen. Is that all that's down here? Yes, it is. But this is a good opportunity. I've got 13,000 souls. I just beat a boss. Great time to go back to Carly and try and see what's changed in the game world, if anything. Has changed. So I take it burning that vertebrae strengthened my, so right now the covenant that I have is Way of the Blue, so I suppose it strengthened my affiliation with the Blue Signal Company. And also I got something else to take to an NPC. Here in Firelink Shrine. I didn't even read this one. I thought they were the same item type. That's why I didn't bother reading them, but the description's different. Young White Branch. A young white branch used to transform into something which blends into the surroundings. Little Dusk's first sorcerer's staff eventually became a seedling. And then three white birch saplings. The young branch is said to still contain echoes of Little Dusk's capriciousness. This is what it was. I think it was give to Ludleth, the Lord of Cinder, but they're not here. And also Umbral Ash of a Resident. With this, the Shrine Handmaid will prepare new items. Well, let me give her the Umbral Ash.
Welcome home, Ashen One. Speak thine heart's desire. Ashen One, to be sovereignless, I'm Ashen One.
Wait a second.
Farewell, Ashni.
I don't give the ashes to her. The Shrine Handmaid. Who? I guess it's not her.
Welcome home, speak.
She's the fire.
Farewell.
Is this a Shrine Handmaid?
Oh, how may I?
It is. Here we go. Alright, wait a second.
Ashen One.
Yes. Okay, so that is it.
Ah, how gracious. Passing fine ash thou hast given. Let this ash bestow nourishment. I only hope these new wares content thee.
Tower behind the shrine. I'm definitely going to buy this one. Great.
Ashen One, if my wares are not to thy sack, bring me umbral ash. With ash, I'll fashion new wares. Is it not our sorry fit?
I think that's old dialogue. Let's take a look at this key. Grave key. Key to the barred door leading from the sewer below the undead settlement. Key to the barred door leading from the sewer below the undead settlement to a moist grave. The grave which no longer receives visitors was once the site of a statue of Velka, goddess of sin, and was believed to pardon wrongdoing and lift curses. And here's Grey Rat, he's back.
Ah, well met. 'Tis good to see ye in good health. What needs smithing this day? Prithee, be careful. I don't want to see my work scorned.
You know what? I'm going to come back and talk to Grey Rat, but I think there's some bone dust I can throw in the fire to strengthen my Estus Blast. Burn undead bone shard. Maybe that just didn't do what I thought it did. Assassin armor, assassin gloves, assassin trousers, thief mask. He does definitely have better arrows. lightning urn. He has a light crossbow as well. That's useful.
Goodbye, and stay safe. Oh, this place is a bore. What good is thievery if you've nowhere to go?
I'm just gonna look at the equipment. I could replace. I don't need a crossbow. Or I can put a crossbow on my main hand. Could do that. Might not be a bad idea.
Oh, hello, you're back. And in one.
Standard crossbow wielded by common soldiers must be readied before firing. Bolts must be equipped in order to use crossbows. Up to two kinds of bolt can be equipped at a time, and these can be switched between if necessary.
Goodbye. Oh, this place.
I'm gonna put it in my main hand as a third weapon.
Oh, hello, you're back, and in one piece. You can keep the ring. As, well, a little trinket of thanks, I suppose. Goodbye, and stay safe.
I haven't talked to this NPC in about three playthrough videos.
Oh, our champion of Ash. Welcome back.
If I recall, yeah, he's a sorcerer.
As I have said, I was once a sorcerer. Alas, the magic of Londor is a far cry from the wonders of Vinheim, but I can teach you what I know, perhaps more importantly. I believe that I can help tease out your true strength. We pilgrims of Londor are keenly aware that those branded by the dark side possess something quite special. Be safe, champion of Ash.
Unkindled one. I am pleased to have a pupil as dedicated as you. To learn pyromancies, I know, but such is the way. And pyromancy, of course.
Thank you.
given up yet. Then you're a brasher lad than I thought. You can make better use of this.
Heavy jet.
I don't need it. Not now I've flown the coop.
A gem of infused titanite, famously used to forge Faron great swords, used in infusion to create heavy weapons. A warrior can appreciate a heavy weapon, for they scale effectively with strength.
Welcome home, Ashen One. Speak thine heart's desire. Very well. Then touch the darkness within me. Take nourishment from these sovereignless souls. Welcome home, Asher. Speak thine. Ashen One, sovereign. I will show.
There's another locked door out here. Not open from this side. Then what? I mean, I've obtained two new keys. Looks like one of these I'm gonna have to go back to the City of Lothric. City of Lothric. really think there's anything across that way. But I'm thinking the jail cell. Deserter trousers. It's like a burning noise. I don't think I ever explored up here. Dragon's corpse? Yeah, I've never explored here. Binoculars. I was wondering where the binoculars were. Like, that's like a staple in the Dark Souls series. How the heck do you get over there to it though? Try up. Unless the entrance is covered by this dragon's corpse. Okay. Gold pine resin. Rare pine resin which emits golden sparks. Chunks of it are even rarer. Temporarily applies lightning to right-hand weapon. Its origins are unknown, although some have speculated that it may in fact be a type of fungal resin. Try it out. That was a good message. So I guess we're gonna head down. We got no other choice. On the other side of the dragon. Rest here. I can go down the ladder. Nice throwing line. I can go through here. I'm looking for doors that I haven't been able to unlock. I don't think there are any out there, so we're gonna go down the ladder. This one. Use lift chamber key. There we go. Now where is this taking me? friendly and inviting at all. Yeah. Ah, it'll happen to you too. What does that mean? Monster. Quagmire. I'm gonna touch this blood stain because Alright. This guy looks like he's gonna be difficult to fight if he's hostile. Binoculars. Where are the binoculars? There they are. Alright, this looks like one of the freaking dark race at the end of Dark Souls 1, toward the end. These guys, if it is, these guys are no joke. Fire ahead. It's beatable, though. Red Eye Orb. Dark leggings and a pale tongue. Red Eye Orb, dark leggings and a pale tongue. Online play item, invade other worlds at will. Defeat the host of embers of the world you have invaded to gain strength of fire. The Red Eye Orb is rooted in a tiny land swallowed by darkness long ago. Some choose to put the orb to other uses. To embark on this path, enter the service of Rosaria in the Cathedral of the Deep. Dark leggings. Leggings of the Dark Rays, relics of a small country that fell to the dark long ago. Look as if they may crumble to dust at any moment. The Dark Rays were the oldest of the Red Eye Invaders and rumored to have served a primordial serpent. This is where I found Grey Rat, I'm pretty sure. This is where I found it. Okay, well, I'm going to head back to the bonfire and I'm going to end the stream here. It's 1 hour and 42 minutes in. Go a little over the 1 hour and 30 mark, but it's not too much. Not too excessive. So this stream was a little more eventful. We actually took out a boss and we killed a Dark Rage. And speaking of which, before I go here, there was an NPC that encouraged me to go kill that Dark Rage. I want to see if he's here or not.
The Undead Legion of Farron is a caravan of undead, sworn by wolf's blood to contain the abyss. The Legion will bury a kingdom at the first sign of exposure. Joyous bunch, really. Gaining admission to the Legion is a matter of some ceremony. Inside their keep, snuffing out the flames of 3 altars opens the door to the wolf blood. Even accursed undead want to believe they're special, it seems. I pity the sorry souls.
Grow weary of your journey. opportunity, you too may become a finger. Come on, give yourself to Rosaria of the Cathedral of the Deep. Now invade and if you grow, come on.
Welcome home, Ashen One. Speak thine heart's desire. Farewell, Ashen One. May the flames guide thee.
Keep the ring as, well, a little trinket of thanks, I suppose. Goodbye, and stay safe. Oh, this place is a bore. What good is thievery if you've nowhere to go?
Okay, so I guess the next area is the Road of Sacrifices. Okay. Anyways, this is going to be the end of the stream, going into an hour and 50 minute territory. So I'm going to cut it off here, pick it back up in Dark Souls 8, and it looks like we're going to go to the Road of Sacrifices next. Peace out.